Hi everybody, my name is Hannah and this is Pepper and Pine, and I have a project to share with you today. We are working on this medieval siege tower with catapult by Pathfinders. It is a complete kit that comes with everything you need in order to make a working siege tower with a catapult. It's awesome. And if you wait till the end of this video, I'm going to show you how we're using it and how we're using it to destroy a little castle that we actually built from plaster a few years ago. So lots of fun. This is a perfect activity for a Middle Ages unit. It's a great activity for a child about 10 years and up. My son is 12 years old and he is going to do this project pretty much entirely on his own. I do help out a little bit at the end, but honestly, he could have done it completely by himself. Now, it did take several hours to do, so be patient. You will need just a couple additional supplies that the kit does not come with. That's tape there on the side, which you need in order to keep the pieces together while they're drying. And also, we did run out of glue, so we did use some of our own glue. But I'm really pleased with the quality of the products in this kit because the glue that it came with is very good quality. It really held everything together, especially if you intend to use this. And so I would recommend just getting a nice sturdy glue. You just don't want your project to fall apart once it's together. I've been asked before whether these projects can be taken apart and stored, and in my opinion, no, just because not only do you need glue in order to put this together, I just find that taking these pieces apart and putting them back together is going to ruin the integrity of the product, and it may not come together as easily the next time you do the project. So I just recommend that if you're going to buy any of these kits, and by the way, there are three that I know of in this series. There's a catapult, a trebuchet, and this medieval siege tower, and all three of them are amazing, high quality, but they do take up a little bit of space. So if you intend to buy this, I just recommend that you intend to complete it and keep it in a place where you can play with it. It's going to take up a little bit of space, but it makes just a great little centerpiece, a showpiece, and of course an awesome activity for this unit. Okay, so my son is making his way through this project. It did take a long time to do. I think we did it over the course of a couple of days, and that actually worked out in our favor because it allowed the pieces to dry completely, which made it a lot easier to progress through the steps because pieces were nice and sturdy as we moved on to later steps. The directions are fantastic. They're easy to follow. The only thing that I would recommend is that you remove the tape once the piece is set, because I found that we had a little bit of a difficult time removing the tape as we continued to build the siege tower because the tape got kind of covered by other pieces. And so there are little bits of tape that were still left on. So as soon as it's set and it's dry, go ahead and remove that tape and then progress on to the next step. I did have a couple of trays that you can see in the corner of the video right now to lay out all of our supplies. We didn't want any of those small dowels rolling off the table and getting lost. And it came with just a couple extra pieces, but overall nothing was broken or split. And so we were able to complete this project without needing to order any additional pieces. All right, so we're about midway through the project at this point. My son is making great progress on this medieval siege engine. This is the first time that we've worked on this project, but because this is our third time working through our Middle Ages unit, having done this about 4 to 5 years ago and also about 8 to 9 years ago, it is not our first time working on these kits. And we have done the trebuchet and the catapult twice before. And I have to say that the quality of these kits is superb, because those kits that we've gotten in the past have held up really well over these last several years. I think there's only the trebuchet and the catapult from the very first time we did this main lesson block that we finally had to discard because it was broken beyond repair. But for the most part, they work really well. They function amazingly well. They really do knock down castles, as you will see at the very end of this video. And the only thing is that because over time, wear and tear, some of the pieces of wood might split. It just ends up breaking over time. But for the most part, for all of the times that my children have played with these kits, they have just been fantastic. And even though this is the first time that we're making the siege tower, I'm pretty confident it's going to hold up as well as the other ones. All right, so we are at the very end of this project. At this point, my son is wrapping around the string at the top of the project in order to make the tension that's going to be needed in order to launch the catapult. And I'm going to show you at the very end of this video how you can adjust the tension in order to get your catapult to go farther or higher, depending on where your castle is and where the position is of your siege tower. So we're at the very end now, and my son is having to sand down the dowels a little bit because they were just a touch too big for some of the pieces. Sandpaper does come in the kit, but I found that working with an emery board sometimes was a little bit easier than the sandpaper that came in the kit. So you might want to just have one on hand in case your dowels are too big. So the kit also comes with some clay, and I made the mistake of thinking it was polymer clay that needed to be baked. So I ruined the clay from this kit, but that's okay. We end up using rocks and other projectiles when we actually use the catapult at the top of the siege tower. The last thing that we need to do before we make the flags is to position these wheels at the bottom of our siege tower. And we had to put the entire thing upside down in order to do this, but you don't want to put it right side up when you're done. Otherwise, the wheels will fall off. They need to dry in place this way first. So now we get to do the fun artistic thing, and that is to decorate our flags. My son chose the letter Z, and then he's just doing a couple other like decorative things. I did one of them to give him an idea on what he could copy since he was at a loss creatively, and that was okay. That was my contribution to this project, and I enjoyed being able to help him with that. And now we're just going to glue these flags at the very top. You do want to be mindful of how you position them, because once you glue them in place, they can't be moved. And we made the mistake of gluing them in two different directions, and we tried to adjust at the end, but overall, doesn't even matter. Once everything is set up, you don't even notice those small details that you think were mistakes while you're working on the project. So we've got this set up in our school room, and you can see our chalkboard in the background and some of the other projects that we've been working on for this Middle Ages unit. But now comes the fun part, and that's when we get to launch the catapult and destroy our castle and that army. So it wasn't quite the right tension. We wanted the catapult to go a little bit farther, have a little bit more force. So my son is adjusting the tension here, and whoops, that goes way too far. That clears the castle entirely. So the next time he just was able to adjust how far back he pulled the catapult so that he could aim it for the castle. I'm going to tell you, this was the funnest part of the whole project, is actually getting to experiment with our catapult and our trebuchet and our siege tower. This is so much fun. Highly recommend all three of these kits. You can find them at Rainbow Resource as well as other vendors. All the information is linked down below. And if you want to check out some of the other videos in our Middle Ages unit, you can tap on the screen right now. And if you want more information about this unit as well as other homeschool lessons that we have done, you can find them on my website at pepperandpine.com. And don't forget that if you want to see what we're up to on a daily basis, you can find me on Instagram at pepperandpine.